In this video, I am going to explain deep lateral rotator of hip joint. There are six muscles, but I explained this muscle for the other video. This is piriformis. So if you'd like to check anatomy video of piriformis, please check that out. So I am going to explain five other muscles. I'm going to start with this one. This is gemellus superior. Gemellus superior. If there is superior, there should be inferior. That is this muscle. This is gemellus inferior. You know, gemellus means twins, okay? So these two muscles are kind of identical. That is why these two are gemellus, superior and inferior. Origin of these two muscles are ischium. Okay? If you look anatomy book, there's more detail about location, but I wanna learn anatomy very simply, so I just remember these two muscles are from ischium, okay? And where's insertion of these two muscles? That's here. This is greater trochanter. Greater trochanter. Greater trochanter is big bony bump on femur, okay? What is function of gemellus superior and inferior? They are same movement. What are they? One main function is, of course, external rotation. Of course, because this is lateral rotator, right? External rotation. This is the main function. There are two other functions. Adduction, okay? Adduction plus extension. External rotation, adduction, and extension. These three movements are function of gemellus superior and gemellus inferior. Okay, now let me explain next muscle. Next one is this one. This is obturator internus. Obturator internus. There's internus, there should be obturator externus. But you can't see obturator externus from this picture, so I'm going to explain obturator externus at last. Okay, origin of obturator externus is, actually there is membrane deep to obturator internus. That is obturator membrane. Obturator membrane. And there is a hole at this point, that's obturator foramen. Foramen means hole, okay? Obturator membrane, obturator foramen. That is why this muscle is obturator internus, okay? This is origin. Insertion is this part. This is very close to gemellus muscles, right? So insertion is greater trochanter. Greater trochanter. I went to a anatomy dissection class and I saw gemellus muscles, obturator internus and obturator externus, their insertion is very, very close. So these four muscles are kind of a neighbor, okay? They are very, very close. Obturator internus, obturator membrane, and greater trochanter. What is function of this muscle? That is, of course, external rotation. Plus, what is it? What is the other function? That is adduction. Okay. And one more thing. That is extension. Okay, it's very simple, right? External rotation, adduction, and external rotation. This is the anatomy of obturator internus. Let's move on to this muscle. Okay, this is quadratus femoris. Quadratus femoris. Quadratus means kind of a rectangular shape. Rectangular muscle on femur. Quadratus femoris. Origin of quadratus femoris is ischium, especially close to ischial tuberosity. Insertion is kind of a wide part of femur. This is close to greater trochanter, but if you want to be very specific, there's name. What is it? That is intertrochanteric crest. Intertrochanteric, that sounds very close to greater trochanter, right? This is specific name, but as I said, I want to be very simple for anatomy. That is why I personally remember this place as greater trochanter. If you are using this video for anatomy exam, yeah, you should remember intertrochanteric crest. But I remember this place as greater trochanter. Simple enough, right? Function of quadratus femoris. Main function is, of course, external rotation. Next one is adduction. Okay? Simple enough. Now, let me change picture of anatomy and let me explain last one, that is obturator externus. Okay, this is front view. This is obturator externus. Obturator externus. Origin is same as obturator internus. Do you remember that? That's obturator membrane. See, there's membrane around obturator foramen. Obturator externus originates from outside part of obturator membrane. Obturator internus originates from the inside part of obturator membrane. That's very, very interesting place. Okay, this is origin. Insertion, where is it? Obturator externus goes posterior to femur and it attaches to very close to greater trochanter. But if you want to be very specific, that is trochanteric fossa. But this is very close to greater trochanter. Do you remember? This muscle is very close to obturator internus, gemellus superior, and gemellus inferior. These four muscles are very, very close. Main function is, of course, external rotation. Then it can do adduction. Very important muscle. I explained five muscles among deep lateral rotator. if you want to add up one more thing, that's piriformis, right? These six lateral rotators are important for lateral rotation, external rotation for hip joint. But there's one more important function, that is stabilization of hip and pelvis. External rotation is of course important. Other functions such as extension and adduction are equally important. However, stabilization of hip joint is as equally important as mobility. Okay, stability. Stability is very, very important. So these five muscles plus piriformis, six muscles, is important for hip stabilization. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of deep lateral rotators. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.